Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Hot Toys Talk, and we don't actually have any Hot Toys display, and the reason why, finally,
do you have to repeat finally?
Aye, because you kept saying it and then you were going to get it, and you never did. Now he finally gets it. What does he get? We're going to do a special episode, an unboxing episode for you. An old figure, guys, he's been out for well over a year now.
We're going to do my unboxing of Robocop. Battle damaged version with Alex Murphy. I did tell you guys I would get him, so there is proof. Another wee insight, I don't want to leave it to the end of the video, I'd rather get it in now. When I paid my final deposit for this, I also put my £50 deposit on Han and Chewie, so all I have to do is pay up the rest, which is £300, which shouldn't be too bad. I said to Jim I could pay it up over the next couple of months coming up. He said that's fine, so as soon as that's done, I'll have another unboxing for these. I'll have Han and Chewie unboxing for these, and that'll be that. But I did tell you I would get them, and I told you I would get them in March, and lo and behold, I kept to my word. I told you I'd get them in March, and I did, and I kept my word true, so. Without further ado,
let's get this bad boy open.
Get this box unveiled.
Well, he is about a year old now, must be.
He's coming up to maybe about a year old. He's not a year old yet, but he's coming up to about that. So, box slides off. And as you can see, you've got the nice protective bit that has all the people that's made it and today with the obviously the figures and all that. So
how much did you like the first Robocop they released?
Well, I liked him, aye, because he was really nice. So then when I found out that this was coming out, you know, I wanted to get it. I knew it was something that, and plus the fact is Alex Murphy, like, actually in his Alex Murphy in his standard cop version, which is good because you don't want him always as Robocop, you know, you want him in his standard version. So obviously here you've got your handcuffs, you've got his watch, compass, his torch, you've got his guns. Obviously, you always get the pegs and all that. You always get spare pegs, whatnot. This is obviously Alex Murphy cop mode version. He's really nice. I like him. He so looks like Peter Weller. He's got that look. Obviously, he's got the changeable head, doesn't he? That you can change, switch it, and put on. Took all these bits off. It's obviously always a nightmare to get these off, but once they're off, they're off.
Oh, the plastic bits?
Plastic bits are always a nightmare to go, but once they're off, and
so are you getting Ed 209? In the bottom of Ed 209?
So, Ed 209, I'll get them after I've got a lot of other priorities. Once I kind of started my Star Wars collection, once I get my Star Wars collection started, I'll probably get Ed 209 somewhere down the line. Also, need to think about, because we've missed out in the chair, and I really do want the chair, but it means you've got to buy another figure to get the goddamn chair.
Yeah,
I
know, you kind of get the chair on its own, it sucks.
Kind of get the chair on its own.
But most people have done that, and most people have.
Most people have just bought the chair, read the figure, and just kept him on the chair. And
then kept the other figure battling.
Kept the other figure battling the 209, which is probably
a good idea,
aye, it is a really good idea.
Because you need something to kind of go with your 209, really, don't you?
Exactly.
But you always said, for any hot toy makers out there, you want something else for that film.
I want a Clans bodyguard. I've always said it. I know it does seem a bit, they kind of just release Clans bodyguard, blah, 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 but if you think about it, this Robocop here has got the bloodied, you know, the spike. So, I mean, he's got the bloodied spike. That goes into the neck of Clans Bodyguard, so You know, to recreate that kind of scene, you would think Hot Toys would go, Clan's bodyguard, then have him with, like, maybe, like, changeable neck, where you can maybe change his neck piece, you can maybe have a bit that you could put on, where you could have, like, a big hole where that spike goes, and you could have the spike going right through, you know, I mean, it's endless.
It's just not really, I think, a villain that... I mean, he's a good villain in the film, but I just don't think he's a great villain that he really...
Yeah, but, well, think
he's
about...
He's not really like a Joker, or he's
no,
not
but,
like...
No, but think about
he's
it...
just a guy.
Think about it, right, he's just a guy, you know, right? Commissioner Gordon's just a guy, and he appears with a bat symbol. I mean...
Well, at least he kind of comes, with...
But who's he, though? He's just a guy.
He comes with at least Robin as well, so...
Right, and you've got the Avengers side characters, you've got her, you've got that woman that's on the... That woman that's...
Her with the shield.
You've got her. I mean, who's she? She's just a side character. I mean, she's not important. She's just a side character. And yet they release her in Hot Toys.
So I'd say
there'll
be a Robocop 2, Jake.
Well, I would love... See if they release Kane. Oh my God, he would be gigantic.
Oh.
I think... See if you release Kane, I think you would need to take one of the glass panels out to fit him in. I think he would reach up to probably that second glass. I think he would be that big. He's huge. I mean, you think about how giant he was in the film. He was a big, massive, big robot thing. And he just had, obviously, he had his head as well. You kind of just think of the body. The body's massive, but he had a big head as well. The size would be gigantic. I mean, I really do think, I think he would touch the bottom of there and he would reach up to probably that second shelf up there. I think that's how big he would be. Actually, yeah. Would be huge, mate. But
then what would they do with Robocop? Because he's pretty much the same. They've never changed his outfit. The only one I'd say they'd probably give us a half a Robocop.
Aye, that's all I would want. See, I would be happy. See, if they give you half a Robocop, all in pure, like, with the mad thing popping out. The thing pops out and it says damaged and all that and stuff. And then you see him with the half face and you see him going, and all that. I think I would be happy with that because we Robocop... Fair enough, he gets damaged when he's fighting Kane. But you could probably recreate that scene as well. You could, if anybody ever had Deadpool 9, you could put the damaged Robocop for the first film and you could have him fighting Kane with damaged.
Yeah.
And you could look like Kane's damaged him and then you could, you know, you could have him...
That would be pretty awesome.
I think it would be. I don't know. Hot Toys obviously have no released. I mean, when is it the next... release when they release what's new coming out.
Comic-Con?
When Comic-Con.
It's coming this June.
Coming June, so June time.
July. So we'll see, like, if there's a Catwoman, if there's a Penguin, is there a Doc Brown? I think these are the things that fans are really wanting.
Are we
getting a C-3PO and...
I think a lot of people will want a Doc Brown.
I think a lot of people will want a Doc Brown.
Doc Brown will be the most...
No doubt about it. See if we end up seeing at Comic-Con this year, Marty McFly Part 3 with car. Part 3 car,
and it's like, okay, right, that's Part 3, but where's Doc Brown? That's what people will end up
picturing. At the moment, we haven't heard anything else about the release date of Marty Part 2, so we're kind of still a bit away. I don't know what's happening with that yet.
I don't know what's happened yet. I mean, it's not actually been, like, released.
Yeah.
It's not been, like... This is out now, get it, and it's like just...
So what do you think of the sculptor?
I think he's the best they could do. There's no way, I mean, Peter...
That's definitely Peter Willett, well, that.
But yeah, definitely.
By far.
Yep. I love the whole outfit, the way they've got it. It's just down to a T, man. I mean, I know a lot of people said as well, a lot of people, when they watched that film, there was people disappointed, you know, they were like, he only joined that department and then all of a sudden he was killed, like, he was just killed, so quick into that film. And it was like, well, it's, you know, it's bound to happen. It's, you know, it's one of the things that's going to happen. He's joined a police department where people are just... getting killed. Lots of cops are getting killed left, right, centre, so... And obviously you get shotgunned, but I don't know how many times in the chest.
Would you ever like to see a new Robocop for a government?
I would love if they released him all pure battle damaged, like blown to bits.
I don't think we're going to see that, but.
But that how?
That's technically. I mean, that technically is his battle damage. That's before he gets battle damaged. It's technically before he.
Yeah, I know, but I would love to see a battle damaged him just all blown to bits. That would be just nice. You know what I mean? Just be nice on the cake. I mean, we don't know what they've got for us, so they could surprise you. They could end up going, by the way, you wanted another villain for Robocop, here's Khan's Bodega, and then we could be surprised. You could go, there you go, it's Khan's Bodega. After me saying all about it, and then they release it, so it's one of their things, isn't it?
You have to use your scissors.
I do, yeah, I think so. I think I'll regret it too soon, I think.
Well, that's the only problem with this, is the opening. I mean, it keeps the figure nice and...
keeps it nice and fresh, but it's a pain in the butt to get it open. Pain in the butt.
At least you know it's brand new and it's not new.
Exactly, well, that's it, isn't it?
But, no, I loved the first Robocop movie. And I like the second. Would you go for a third Robocop movie?
Nah.
Oh,
I've seen they've got a toy in Forbidden Planet for Robocop 3. It's like, oh, so cringe. You want to buy, who would buy it?
The jetpack thing, yeah.
Who would buy that? And then it's that whole scene, as loyal as a puppy, it's just that whole scene, just like, it's so off-putting. It's like, no, just terrible. And then you've got them mad samurai guys that look, who the hell are they supposed to be?
Was it like a new Robocop from the new movie?
I don't think so. The Ed 209s were awesome in that movie. Don't get me wrong.
Was it like a black Robocop?
I don't think so. I didn't like the whole way he died and all that. I think he died rather crap, to be honest.
There you go, I got that one out for you. Display it. What do you think?
To be honest, man, I mean, by the look of that, guys, I know you just kind of see, obviously, for that distance, but by the look of that, the look I'm looking at, he just looks amazing. He looks so detailed. He looks so, so awesome. I mean, I can't wait. What I'll do for these guys is, when I've got them along in my room, I'll pose them up along in my room and I'll do a wee video or something on my phone, and then I'll send the video to my friend, I'll send it to his phone, and then he can put it up. I could go, hi guys, here's my Alex Murphy, my Robocop in my room, posing him up and all that, here you go, here's what he looks like next to my actual Robocop, and then have him all. Of more up and at him. And then I'll have him, and then hopefully somewhere down the line, don't know if it's this year or maybe next, I'll maybe decide maybe to go for the Ed 209, because I really would like the Ed 209 to complete the kind of
collection.
I'd love to just have the
Ed 209. Would you go for the chair though? Is the debating where to go? There's a stand for that.
I do kind of want to stay at the chair as well. When you first got Robocop, I remember your words, oh, I don't really care about the chair. Chairs.
But then you were
going
to go for it, then you never cared for
them. And then I was going to go for the chair, but then I noticed the chair was like in Forbidden Planet. It was £100 more to get him with the chair than without the chair, and I was like, wow, £100 more just to get a chair. It's like £349.99, and you could get him for like £249.99, like single, the first version. And like, I'll just get him without the chair.
Well, that'll do it for this episode, this special unboxing episode for you guys. I want to thank Tom for being a sport and opening down his unboxing on the show instead of doing it in his room or whatever way they do it.
Yep.
So, till next week, guys, until we go back to our normal news episode again. Keep collecting, guys.